Pathology of urinary stones. First of all, how urinary stones are formed. Mechanism of stone formation. There are many theory for the mechanisms of stone formation. The most famous is the condition is multifactorial, and many factors predispose to stone formation. First of all, nucleus for stone formation. If there is any foreign body in urine, this predispose to stone formation. How? If there is foreign body, this nucleus, this nucleus allow crystals to coalesce and aggregate around this nucleus, leading to formation of a small stone and more aggregation of crystals, leading to growth of the stone and so on. Also, urinary proteins may help the crystals to coalesce together and to adhere together. What is the urinary proteins? Abnormal proteins in case of infections. If there is severe urinary tract infection and tissue exudate containing excessive fibrinogen, and this fibrinogen will lead to fibrin leading to adherence of crystals together with this fibrin, leading formation of thrombus. Also, decrease of stone inhibitors. Normal urine containing mucoproteins and citrates, and these substances inhibit crystal aggregation. If these stone inhibitors are decreased, and this allow to crystal aggregation and stone formation. Therefore, these are the steps of formation of stones. If the urine becomes saturated solution of crystals and the hypersaturated solution of crystals, this lead to aggregation of crystals forming a foreign body and the crystal nucleation. More and more aggregation on this nucleus, leading to stone formation and stone growth. What are the types of stones? The types of stones are four main types: oxalate stones, phosphate stones, strovite stone, and uric acid stones. This is the first stone, which is the commonest stone, which is calcium oxalate stone. The composition of the stone, from its name, it is oxalate, therefore it is calcium oxalate, and it precipitates in normal pH of urine, which is acidic, and usually single. Why single? From its surface. Single stone, which is very small, the surface of this stone is spiky, leading to abrasion of the uroepithelium with hemorrhage and the severe pain. Therefore, it is diagnosed very early while the stone is single stone. Usually moderate in size, oval in shape. The surface is a spiky surface, and the crystals of oxalate is originally this color, whitish. But we said before that the spiky mammillated surface produce hemorrhage, and the altered blood on the surface of the stone gives this brownish color, which is actually altered the blood on the surface. Consistency is very, very hard. For the Arabic student, very hard, عاملة زي الزلطة. عارفين الزلطة اللي بيبنوا بيه شايفين hard ازاي؟ دي زيها بالظبط. Very, very hard. In cut section, it shows radiating spicules, which are the crystals. Radiating, for the Arabic student, زي أشعة الشمس. Radiating like sun rays. It contains calcium oxalate. Therefore, it is sure radiobic. The second type of stone is calcium phosphate stone. Calcium phosphate stone, which consists of calcium phosphate from its name, and strophite stone. Strophite stone is phosphate stone, but it is called triple phosphate stone because it's formed of calcium, magnesium, and ammonium phosphate. These two types of stone are phosphate stones. Precipitate in alkaline urine. Therefore, this is typical example F of a stone formed due to infection with B. proteus, which split urea to ammonia, leading to alkaline urine with precipitation of phosphate, especially this type, which is strophite stone. In a strophite stone, nearly always there is UT infection. What is the number of the stones? Variable. And size, usually large size, and they may reach to fill the whole pelvic cell system, leading to the formation to what is called the staghorn stone. Staghorn stone means branching stone, occupying the whole renal pelvis, branches to the major and branch to the minor crises, like the staghorn. For the Arabic student, زي قرون الوعل. الوعل ده يا جماعة اللي هو ذكر الغزالة اللي بتشوفوه في أفلام كده هو وبرامج عالم الحيوان. تلاقي كده هو غزلتين وكل غزالة طلع منها قرون كده مشعبة، ده الذكر اللي هو بيتقال عليه الوعل. ويقعدوا الوعلين دول يضربوا دماغهم في دماغ بعض وقرونهم في قرون بعض عشان بيتخانقوا على ايه؟ على النتاية اللي هي الفيميل. وبعدين بيني وبينك ساعة ما بيتعبوا من كتر ما بيتعبوا من كتر ايه ضرب دماغهم في بعض بيزهقوا ويقول لك ايه ما تستاهلش ويروحوا سايبينها هما الاثنين وايه وماشيين. فالراجل ده بقى اللي هو ايه الذكر بتاع الغزالة ابو قرون متشعبة قوي. This is the stag horn and called the stag horn stone. Stag horn stone usually always phosphate stone, either calcium phosphate or strophite stone. Calcium phosphate and strophite stone may be oval or amorphous. What is meant by amorphous? Amorphous means has no shape or no features, like this. No shape, no special shape, called amorphous stone. The surface of the stone may be smooth or jagged. Jagged means rough surface, like this, rough surface. The stone is yellowish white, and for the Arabic student, phosphate stone ديا إلى حد ما قرب التباشير اللي احنا بنكتب بيها على الصبورة، لأن هي التباشير عبارة عن كالسيوم فوسفيت على فكرة. ف فده لونها كده هو شبه الطباشير بس مصفر شويه من الانفكشن اللي عامل الالكالين يونين وخلاها تترسب. Both are hard inconsistency but friable for Arabic students زي التباشيرة. Due to infection there may be in cut section nucleus and lamina. In X-ray both containing calcium therefore are radiobic and the stone in X-ray show nucleus and laminae. For the Arabic student عاملة زي قشر البصل laminated. The last stone is uric acid stone. Uric acid stone variable in number consists of uric acid precipitated in normal pH of urine which is acidic, usually small, oval in shape. Uric acid is yellow, golden yellow in color, and hard in consistency, no nucleus or lamina, and it is the only stone in X-ray called translucent stone. Translucent means not appear in the plain X-ray. The last stone is cysteine stone. Cysteine stone is rare. It is amino acid containing sulfur, and sulfur is yellow in color. Multiple is small and radiobic. Very, very rarely there is also what is called thanosine stone. This is a pathology of urinary stones, but finally, before we leave the pathology, how to remember this large table. There are four main types of stone, as we said, oxalate, phosphate, strovite, and uric acid. The structure from the name, oxalate formed of calcium oxalate, phosphate formed of calcium phosphate. Strovite are triple containing calcium, magnesium, and ammonium phosphate. Uric acid is formed of uric acid. Two formed in alkaline urine, infected urine, which are phosphate and strovite, precipitated in alkaline infected urine. But the other two, oxalate and uric acid, formed in normal acidic urine. Oxalate is the only stone which usually single because it is spiky and mammillated, gives the early symptom diagnosed early while it is single. While the other stones all are variable, maybe 1, 2, 3, any number. The size, uric acid is small. Oxalate usually moderate, while the two brothers, which are phosphate and strovite stones, are large stone and may produce staghorn stone. Shape. All are oval. This is also oval, maybe round or oval, or are oval. Or the two brothers, phosphate and strobite, usually amorphous. Amorphous means has no specific form. For the Arabic student, ملهاش معالم, ملهاش شكل محدد. Surface is small, smooth, or jagged. Jagged means rough surface. The characteristic surface is oxalate, which is spiky and mammillated, leading to hemorrhage from the uroepithelium, and the altered blood gives its surface brown or black coloration. All other stones are yellow, yellowish white in the two brothers, calcium phosphate and strovite, golden yellow in uric acid. All urinary stones are hard, very hard in oxalate, hard and friable in the two brothers, calcium phosphate and strovite. Cut section characteristic in oxalate, like radiating like the sun rays, radiating spicules, and the nucleus and delaminated in the two brothers, calcium phosphate and strovite. All are radiobic stones except uric acid stones, radiolucent. Therefore, all radiobic except uric acid, all hard, all yellowish white or golden yellow, but brown or black in oxalate. All are oval, small, moderate, large. Only single stone usually oxalate. All others are variable. Two in acidic, oxalate and uric acid. Two in alkaline, the two brothers. And the structure according to the name. This is the pathology of urinary stones. Thank you for good listening and good luck.